Tonight we are talking about the Kilkerran 8-year-old Sherry Cask 2024 edition, bottled at 57.4% ABV, natural color, non-chill filtered. All of the information right there on the bottle, the way that it's meant to be. So tonight we are definitely ticking the boxes for me. Now, I did some reviews on Kilkerran, some of the heavily smoky ones. Wasn't that big of a fan, but it was nice, it was drinkable. You've never heard me raving about this whiskey. For me, it was, sometimes a hit and a miss. But welcome to the Whisky Lover Society with me, Gert Retief, and tonight we are talking about that Sherry Cask influence, Kilkerran 8 years old, a little bit of a sherry monster, they say. Well, we will see. And of course, natural. There is a little bit of a viscosity, not much. There is some legs forming, but it's not really slow, quite running fast down the glass. Now, price-wise, I'm not really going to talk about the price because it's all over the place. Doesn't matter which shop you try, it's going to be a different price point, which is sometimes a little bit annoying if your one shop is so cheap, much cheaper or much more expensive than the previous shop. So not going to talk about the price. If you can find it, it's one of those whiskies that falls in that spring bank category for me. You need to be quick if you want to buy a bottle, and if you're going to buy one, be prepared to pay a little bit extra for the privilege of getting a bottle like this. Just a little bit more on the whiskey. Of course, it is a single malt Scotch whiskey. It is from the Glengyle Distillery. It is one of their Cask Strength editions. And batch number 10, as I already said, from 2024. And I'm quite looking forward to giving this a nose and a taste. Now on the nose, cheers. There is definitely a strangeness to this one. And if I compare it to a normal, maybe a Highland Sherry Cask whiskey, is a big difference in this one for me. And it really got the mind going to find the notes. What am I smelling? The rat is running around, a little bit confused. From which memory bank do I find these aromas? So definitely a little bit of a strangeness. And I think it's got to do with that Oloroso mixed with a hint of a peat, a little bit of a smoky note. So the aromas for me is quite different from the normal sherry cask. It takes a little bit of time to understand what you are smelling because of the difference note. And when I get past that initial shock, strangeness, and when you start to pick up that familiar notes, and the first thing that I got is a little bit of a dark chocolate note. Not much, but it's there. And then there's a lovely sweetness coming in. And when you are hit with that little bit of that vanilla, I get some raisins and I get a little bit of that date notes. So within a little bit of time, that initial volatility for me gently goes away. And you are left with that nice sweetness and a little bit of that smoke in the end. And it reminds me of a little distance bonfire smoke. And every time when I go back, it feels like it's getting a little bit more friendly. And with time in the glass, a little bit more mellow. Wake it up. Oh my word, this is nice. Definitely a sherried whiskey. And with that hint of that peat, it's really, really right at the back. Sometimes I'm not sure, is it actual peat? Is it smoke? Because it, with the time, Your nose also get climatized, and that chocolate note gets elevated for me a little bit. Really nice. On the taste, cheers. It is a sweet one. It is a strong boy. There's a hotness in it. There's a little bit of a viscosity to it. That chocolate note. And when you are hit with that smoke, I would say it feels like almost double from what the nose would have suggested. Again, with that little savory bonfire type of smoke. Quite pleasant, actually. Give me one more try. It is 57.4%. It didn't feel very high on the mouth. It feels like maybe 46% ABV. So definitely no need for me to add water. If you want to add water, feel free. But nice sipper for me. Let me give it one more try. Definitely a little bit of a punchy note. But after the second sip, that punchy note is definitely not there anymore. The mouth is acclimatized to that high ABV, that sweetness, that raisins, the dates note coming through. There's a little bit of a dark chocolate also coming through. This is really nice. Now, I also detect just a little bit of a caramel note. Almost no bitter notes. It is 8 years old, so it did not really extract any of that tannins, that bitter notes, the dark coffee notes. I'm not getting any of that. It is just a lovely sweet, quite sweet actually. My type of whiskey, my type of, a smoky whiskey. It's really interesting. If you compare it to maybe one of these Johnny Walker Black labels, you will also say there is smoke. For me, it's very difficult to detect that smoke. Maybe on the taste, it's just a hint of that. Now, this is, for me, just a little bit above that, and you get a little bit more of that smoky notes. An interesting whiskey. I think it's a challenging whiskey. I think you need to spend a little bit of time with the whiskey before you're going to enjoy it. I think that strangeness plays a big role for me. When I poured it, I wasn't sure if I liked it. When I started investigating a little bit and I found all of these different aromas coming out, I like that idea that it challenges you. And it's not like one-dimensional of one or two notes and the rest is there's nothing. Definitely something that I would recommend. One sip. Really nice. This is really a nice whiskey, a friendly whiskey, but you need to give it a little bit of time. So thank you very much for watching. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. And I see you next time. Cheers.